experience 4 deals with gram-negative bacteria. Let's take a look at this. One thing we deal with when we talk about gram-negative bacteria is water quality. Gram-negative bacteria tend to be associated with the human digestive system, and it says that human fecal matter is carried by water in sewage systems that often empties into rivers or lakes. One of the things in the United States is we tend to have a very excellent water system in urban areas that does not necessarily carry throughout the rest of the world, or in the United States in very rural areas. Wise man once said, either you have a water filter or you are a water filter. And that, if you think about that, that's rather striking. Municipal water supplies test for the presence of fecal microorganisms. And the indicator organism that they use is a coliform bacteria called Escherichia coli, or E. coli for short. And it gives a very good indication of fecal contamination. Water standards in the U.S. say the maximum number of coliforms permitted in each 100 mLs of drinking or of water. It says drinking water less than one coliform, swimming water less than 200 coliform, boating water less than 2,000 coliform. And when you start thinking about it, that's because in boating water, you aren't drinking it, hopefully. And, you know, when you're swimming, again, you aren't necessarily drinking it. So they can have higher levels in there, but drinking water, to be safe, we really want about one coliform or less per 100 ml. The Ganges River in India averages over 10,000 coliforms per 100 ml. The New Orleans flood water was estimated at about 24.5 million coliforms per 100 ml, which is really extremely contaminated, and that's why it was quite problematic to go out and walk around in that water. The main fecal coliform, again, is going to be E. coli. It is a gram-negative rod-shaped bacterium. We call them bacilli. It is non-endosperm-forming. It is a lactose fermenter. It produces gas in 48 hours, and it's aerobic or facultatively anaerobic. The family that it belongs to is the Enterobacteriaceae. And this is a family of gram-negative bacilli. They are all glucose fermenters, and they are all oxidase negative. So there are certain characteristics, but those are, you know, two very distinct characteristics that we look here. Now, how do we detect these things? It says we're going to run specific tests to identify the organisms. Let's remember, bacteria are very tiny. Since we don't have a lot we can go on, we have to identify them using biochemical tests. And these biochemical tests will help us differentiate and distinguish between species. So one species may be able to do something and another species may not. And we use all of these differences to be able to break them apart. There are a lot of different tests that we are going to use. It says over here, one of the tests we're going to use is the Indole test. And you can read about this in the Atlas. It is done on Sims Media. Basically, the Indole test tests for tryptophanase. There is tryptophan in the medium. If the tryptophanase is present, it's going to break down into pyruvic acid plus indole. Then indole is going to react with our reagent that we put in, and it's going to develop a color. If we have two tubes here, these have had the reagent added to it. You can see the one on the left has a little bit of color change, but it's kind of a beige color, whereas the other one has developed a very distinctive red color. The cherry red color is an indicator for the presence of indole. So we look at the ring on the top of the media in this particular case, and we know that that is indole positive. The medium, Sims medium, also can tell us about sulfur reduction. If an organism is able to reduce sulfur, what happens is we get a black precipitate in it. So with sulfur reduction, you get that black precipitate in there, and then that black precipitate will give us that particular coloration that becomes very important. Now, when we look at Sims media, you can have sulfur reduction and indole negative. You can have sulfur reduction and indole positive. You can have no sulfur reduction, indole negative, no sulfur reduction, indole positive. So we actually get four tests out of this particular media. The two tubes on the left-hand side are sulfur reduction negative. We also have the citrate test. This is done on Sim and citrate agar, which test if the organism can use citrate as the sole source of carbon. The citrate gets broken down into carbon dioxide. The excess sodium that is present in the media will combine with the carbon dioxide to create sodium carbonate, which has an alkaline pH that will increase the pH of the culture media. And as it does that, we develop a nice blue color for a positive result. The original result that we would have is green. So you can see the blue color being the very distinctive positive result for citrate. We also have what we call carbohydrate fermentation tests. And these detect the ability of an organism to ferment certain kinds of carbohydrates. There are a lot of different kinds of carbohydrates we can use. You know, this just gives a few. It says glucose, adonatol, lactose, arabinose, sorbitol, ducitol. There are many other ones that we could actually test for in here. The way the test works is the medium is made up of carbohydrate plus a peptone plus a pH indicator. After a growth of up to 48 hours, some organisms are what we call deaminators, and they will break down the peptone, and as they do that, it will create a more basic reaction, which will give us a bright red color rather than the standard orangish type culture media that we have. That is not considered to be a positive result in the carbohydrate fermentation test. On the other side, if we get fermentation end products, we can get production of acid. The acid is going to change the pH medium, and as it does that, the indicator changes to a yellow color, and we call that a positive result. So the tube on the left-hand side has got a positive result for acid production. The tube also has a little tube on the inside that traps any gas that is released, and we can see that as bubbles trapped on the inside of the little tube, and we would record that as a positive. No bubbles would be a negative. We also have what we call the enterotube system, which it says is a multiple test system. It basically looks like this. And this is very interesting. If you take off the little white cap, what you see is the little picture in there where it's got a needle that you can pick up your bacterium on. Under the blue cap, it's got a little hook. You pull on the hook, that's going to pull the needle through the center of the tube. You get it all the way out in the last part, then you push it back, then you break it off. We have a separate video that shows how to do this. The enterotube is considered to be a multiple test system because you've got 15 different results in 11 different compartments. We also have ways to identify these things using different types of agar. This talks about eosin methylene blue agar. The eosin and the methylene blue inhibit the growth of gram-positive bacteria, which makes it selective for gram-negative bacteria. It is also differential. It is differential because it allows for the differentiation of lactose fermenters. When an organism ferments lactose, it's going to produce acid. If it's a very vigorous fermenter, it's going to go one way. If it's a moderate fermenter, it's going to give a different color. And down here, you can see this particular plate where it looks like on the right-hand side, we got no growth. And then we have three different materials in here. One of them looks very pink, and the other two look a little bit purplish. And that shows our differentiation in here. Up here, we've got E. coli. Now, there were two bacteria streaked in this. The bacteria on the bottom didn't grow, but the E. coli on the top did. And it is a vigorous lactose fermenter, so it actually produces this very characteristic metallic green sheen, which is very, very important to be able to look at. So, eosin methylene blue agar, another tool we have for identifying these bacteria in real life.